Hello all. Today we will discuss about quantitative Buffy-Coe test, and myself Dr. Taruna Swami, and I am associate professor in microbiology department of SP Medical College, Bikaner. Now the learning objective of QBC test are: why this test is done, what is the principle of test, how the test is done, what are various advantages and disadvantages of this test over other tests for diagnosing malaria. We all know that quantitative Buffy-Coe test is a test to diagnose malaria, and this test was diagnosed by Becton Dickinson, USA. First of all, the test was developed by Becton Dickinson, USA, and this is a simple method of diagnosing malaria. For this test, only a small quantity of blood, that is only 50 to 100 microliter of blood, is required. The principle of the test is that acridine orange is a fluorescent dye which stains DNA green and RNA red. Nuclei of WBC, reticulocyte, and of parasites, whether they are Plasmodium or Babesia, they appear bright apple green if they are stained with the dye acridine orange. But normal RBC, they don't show any fluorescence. So the principle of the test is, in this test we use a fluorescent dye which is acridine orange. So capillary tubes pre-coated with acridine orange stain, they are taken up, and in that we take patient blood, and then these capillary tubes, they are spun in a centrifuge machine at 12,000 revolutions per minute, and after that the acridine orange dye will stain the nuclei of the parasite as well as cells, nuclei of the cells. DNA material is stained green and RNA is red. So this is the principle of test. On centrifugation of blood, the blood separates into various components based on density. The plasma will comprise upper layer, thereafter Buffy-Coe layer will be there, then RBC layer will be there. Out of these RBC layer, parasitized RBC, they are lighter than the normal one. So beneath the Buffy-Coe layer, there will be parasitized RBC layer. So this parasitized RBC, this layer will be above all other RBC layer. And found these parasitized RBC, they are found just beneath the Buffy-Coe layer. So this is the principle of this test. We can see this is the capillary tube which has been spun, and this is pre-coated with the acridine orange dye. So this is the plasma layer which is shown here, and beneath this plasma layer, Buffy-Coe layer is there, which comprises different type of leukocytes, and this is the RBC layer. So beneath the Buffy-Coe layer, there immediately below this layer, there will be parasitized RBC layer, because these RBC, they are lighter than the other RBCs. So we can focus here under the microscope, and since these RBC, they contain the parasite Plasmodium, so the nuclei of Plasmodium, DNA material and RNA material will be stained with the acridine orange dye which has been pre-coated in these capillary tubes. Now we can see this microcapillary tube. This, the region of the float has been enlarged, so after centrifugation that capillary tube will look like this. Here we have enlarged this view. So this is the Buffy-Coe. So beneath this Buffy-Coe layer, RBC, parasitized RBC layer will be there. So under fluorescent microscope, when we focus the area containing parasitized RBC, we will be able to see the Plasmodium parasite. And this is the ring form having apple green color. And these are the gametocytes of Plasmodium falciparum. So Plasmodium falciparum, this is single ring, and these are gametocytes of Plasmodium falciparum. So when we observe under the fluorescent microscope, the parasite will look like this. What are various advantages of this test? Sensitivity is comparable to thick smear. This method is comparable to thick smear sensitivity. And this can detect up to 3 to 4 parasites per microliter of blood. And this requires lesser training. What are various disadvantages of this QBC test? This test is expensive one, and because expensive equipment is required in terms of fluorescent microscope and these capillary tubes. And the second disadvantage is that differentiation of species is difficult in this QBC test. Hope you like my video. So please like and subscribe Microbiology Lectures by Dr. Taruna Swami. Thank you all.